station, Farringdon.
I'm here at Farringdon. Now you can just go to the regular exit, but that's the same as the Tube and Thames link. I would like to go to the new exit, which is of course the Barbican exit.
That's where we're going.
To the lift. But it's not a lift. It's one of the Elizabeth Line's very few inclinators. Here it is. It's another cone, I think. Along with seeing all the new entrances, and this here is the Barbican exit at Farringdon. Now I would walk to the Tube at Barbican, but we don't need it. But anyway, this is the Barbican exit at Farringdon. We're not getting off at Liverpool Street. The reason you'll find out later.
Liverpool Street. This is the train to Abbey Wood via Canary Wharf. Next station, Whitechapel.
Welcome to Whitechapel. Are you clear of the closing doors? Miss Tranini is ready to depart.
before the underground had a temporary structure, which was a basic box. But now they've reused the old underground entrance. So the old underground entrance looks the same until you go down to the Elizabeth line. And it looks amazing. Let's go. Just like all the stations, they have lots of signs. And it's really nice. Guys, it's huge. But the thing is, we're underground. One single escalator and a couple of steps takes us above the ground. Isn't it just amazing? This bit here is the only bit left of the original Whitechapel station. I'll show it to you. What's called? It says that you've got the normal English font. And then here, you've got this other font. Somebody said it's Arabic. So yeah, you've got the Arabic font there and the English font there. Whitechapel is now one of the biggest interchange stations, as it says the tube. The overground and Elizabeth line. Just for you, Whitechapel. Also, they have to put the maze there again.
Another cone.
Ticket hall and route to train.